Welcome to the first chapter of your text, introducing what is geography. So I just like to take a couple moments to kind of outline really what this text is going to be encompassing, how to read it, how to interpret it, and how to work through it. What's interesting is that this text was written by Dr. Steve Graves at Cal State Northridge, and he bestows the feeling that as a geographer we're like young Jedis, and that we have this force in which we can interpret landscapes, cultures, people, places, and things like that. So I kind of want to introduce that and really kind of go through the PowerPoint that's been provided by the publisher, which is Dr. Steve Graves. So the big thing is, like, how's this course going to work? Obviously, you're going to work through the book itself. You have PowerPoints to go with. This is notes, really, as you're going to go through the text, and reading quizzes that come directly from the text. Again, the book is really organized with a lot of inserts relating back into the Star Wars piece and the Young Jedis, is that we can interpret the landscape. We have these discourses, this way to visualize the places that we are and understand what it is. You know, what is it that we stand facing? So perhaps you come into a location that has a different language written on billboards, or you see a neighborhood where there's bars on windows, or maybe you go into a different community with different colors of paints and colors and things like that that are on the walls. That is all part of that interpretive landscape piece. And then we can then make extrapolations to try to understand the culture and diversity. So the big thing here is looking. The first chapter is just introducing how this book is to read, how are we to interpret it, and how do we really understand the landscape. So kind of introduced before in my previous video, I kind of talked about how cultural and human geography, which are really the same term in this piece, is really about understanding people, place, and location, and how broad it is. And we're really lucky to live in California because we can see a little bit of everything throughout the entire state. So we can go up into the Central Valley where they do a lot of wine, but it has the landscape using the different trees and the winery and architecture design of going to places like in Italy, or we can go to different places in maybe Southern California, more in Los Angeles region, to see more of the Spanish colonial style housing. We can go to really anywhere within our landscape to see ranch styles and really be able to see the world in such a very small location, which is pretty cool. So that's really what this first chapter is about, is, well, how do we look at these core values? How do we look at diffusion? How do we look at just people and place? Again, the text is really different than most texts because you'll see that he makes a lot of reference to things that he was very passionate about, you know, predominantly architecture, but also looking at hip-hop and different types of music trends, because again, those are all cultural pieces, influences. So when you think of culture, well, what is that? Well, there's its influence, things that are pulled and derived from different people, things along that line. So just really to kind of interpret those aspects. Another thing that he's really adamant and really strong about is he did a lot to fight against payday lenders. Those are the people that you could take your paycheck and or a check and they would post-date it and cash it and give you, you know, money up front, but then charge you like 400% interest. So he talks a lot about that and where that spatial distribution is. So those are not necessarily extremely important pieces of this text and what I'm going to be expecting of you, but it's still, I'm not going to nitpick what you can look in and out of. It's just more interesting because there's when we start looking at cultural landscapes, when we start talking about crime, when we start talking about agriculture, when we start talking about gender roles and architectural and landscape design, we will see that there is a place and space. And so he utilizes a lot of GIS, which is geographical information systems, where you actually plot using a computer where these locations are. You can then use statistics to, you know, predict change and influence and diffusion. Therefore, you can kind of bring those attributes in. So anyway, the first chapter is really just introducing the book, the text, and kind of bringing in that background Star Wars motif that, you know, you already have these senses. You already have this way to interpret a landscape. It's just now learning to identify the terms and the words as so that we can easily discuss, express, and then to use critical thinking to understand really what it is that we stand facing. So enjoy the first chapter, and we'll talk soon.